Hello everyone. In this video, I will explain the second script we have provided to you, the Google Earth Engine script. The script name is GEE underscore exercise 2. I have given you the link. Please open the link and it should open in your code editor. Do just add some words or add a comment. Then the save button will be active and please save the script into your own repository. So you can see that here in this exercise, finding irrigated area using thresholding, and let's see how it can be accomplished using script in Google Earth Engine. So the first step is to import the Meandob irrigation system asset here. I have already provided this shapefile to you, so you can also import it into your own assets and import it here. But as I said in my earlier video, I'm sharing my assets with you, so you can also read this. And now the first step is to center the map view to the study area, which is MIS with a zoom level of 8. Now the second step is to import three Landsat images of 24th May 2019, 27 July 2019, and 28th August 2019. Here we are specifically importing those Landsat images of those dates, and each patch or each set of code, this set shows how to import the first patch. You can see that we are importing with respect to the path and row 16834. So you can replicate the same code into your future studies to do the same. And here we are defining the visualization palette for Landsat 8 because we want to visualize it in false color composite, and this is how we will do it. We'll give the bands which are required for false color composite, which are band 5, 4, and 3. Now here we are adding, using this visualization parameter or palette, we are adding these three images. So here you see that I have a bug already. So three images I'm going to add here using the same visualization in false color composite. Now in this exercise we'll use NDVI. So we are defining a palette for NDVI here between 0 and 1, white to green. You can also edit it. You can put minus 1 here instead of 0. It's up to you. Now, let us compute NDVI using normalized difference function. So there is a function available in Google Earth Engine, normalized difference. So we are going to use this function to compute NDVI. So in this one line, I'm computing NDVI for the first image, which is IMG1, which is 24th May 2019. So there's a function we give in bands 5 and 4, rename the band name into NDVI and clip to MIS in one single line. So, likewise, we repeat for image 2 and image 3. If you want to visualize, you can uncomment this and try to visualize it, but I'm commenting it because I don't want to see that in the map view. It's up to you. Now we want to create a mean NDVI from these three images. So here you can see I'm using add to add three NDVI images, image 1 dot add image 2 dot add image 3, and then this added images divided by 3, which will give you mean NDVI. And here we are visualizing the mean NDVI. Now let's get into temperature, which we decided that we will use band 10 for temperature. Now this is the palette definition for temperature. I'm going to select the band 10 from each image, IMG1, IMG2, IMG3, and add them together and divide by 3 to get mean temperature. In this line, I'm converting the temperature from Kelvin to degree Celsius and clip to the scheme. So mean temperature dot subtract 273.15 will give you degree Celsius and clip it into MIS. You can add layer to visualize this mean temperature in degrees. Now I am applying. Now let us assume that all the pixels in Meandob scheme with NDVI higher than 0.3 and temperature lower than degrees Celsius belongs to irrigated agriculture. Let's assume that we got it using some statistics, or just find out how to do that in Google Earth Engine itself. You can always find mean and percentile here. Now let's apply those thresholds. Let's see how to apply those thresholds. And this is this line. Let's apply that. So I'm saying mean NDVI dot greater than 0.3. So a new variable irrigation irrig underscore mask, where mean NDVI is greater than 0.3, and this and is important. Mean temperature less than 33. So whenever those pixels meet these two criteria, it will add those pixel value 1 and add to irrigation mask. And now we have 1 and 0 in irrigation mask, but we don't need zeros. We want zeros to be no data. So the below line convert all the zeros to no data. Now in this line, you can visualize the irrigated mask. You can export with this patch of line or set of lines. You can export irrigation mask to the drive in your Google Drive as TIFF. Here you can, in this set of lines, you can calculate or compute the area of irrigated area in square meters. Run it and see how it looks. You can see I have added all the three measures in FCC, mean NDVI, mean temperature, and irrigation mask. It should appear somewhere here, and the area is also showing here. So the area is around 616 square kilometer inside the Myanthar irrigation. So this is how it looks. Thank you. Explore documentation for more details on each functions.